Okay, so what we have here is the test situation of the EJ205. Just chucked it on a pallet and then strapped the pallet to a little trolley. And over here I've got the OBD2 port plugged in up to the computer, and it's running free SSSM. And I've just got it highlighted on, where is it, the airflow sensor, which isn't plugged in. And I've also magnified it so you can see the value from when we're way over by the engine. But yeah, we're going to plug in the air mass airflow sensor. This one here, the broken one we got. Just going to chuck it in here, and we're going to do this with. Just put this down for a sec. Plug it in. Any minute now. Okay. Yeah, there we go, sorry about that. But we've plugged that in. And just hang that there. And then over here, we're gonna get our key. Start the car so that it's on. Where the hell? Yeah. So that's on. So now the car is ready to be connected up here. Click start. Then straight away you can see that the mass airflow sensor has now got a value of 1.10 volts. So what we can do now to test out that mass airflow sensor, so you can get a hold of it and blow through it, and at the same time we'll see that number up there change. So I can't blow as hard as a turbo sucking, but yeah, you can see it changes from, I'm guessing the voltage will be from 1 volt to 5 volts, something around there. ECU will eventually calibrate the normals and stuff and work out what to do from there. So if we get the key, wherever I put the key, I always put the key in a different place every time. Turn it off. Click stop up here. Unplug the mass airflow sensor. And chuck in this B4 one that you gave me. This one was really quite scungy. Yeah, I'm gonna have to put you down again. Just for a sec. Plug that in. Yeah, so that's the B4 plugged in. Turn on the ignition. Every time it's a different strategy. Ignition's on, chuck key over there. Press start. And look at that. Instead of being 1.10 volts, it's 0.02 volts. Something's very bad with that mass airflow sensor. So we blow through it. Nothing changes. Still 0.02 volts. Wouldn't it be the way that the broken mass airflow sensor is the one that we need to use? Isn't that usually the way? The other mass airflow sensor you gave me works quite well as well. But I still can't figure out the problem with my fiery piece of shit.